Hi, I'm Orlando Terry, Instructional Technology Facilitator here at North Vance High School. And one of my roles is to mentor upcoming technologists, so to speak, in the high school. And so we have the opportunity to train interns. And so what I would like to do is I would like to demonstrate by way of an instructional video of how you set up a laptop after imaging. And so what is imaging? That is when you use the proper software to restore the laptop back to its manufacturer state after students have pretty much corrupted the laptop via viruses. So after we re-image the laptop, then we go into a process called where we set the laptop back up through Windows. So there are approximately 7 screens that are involved in this process, and what we would do is go through each screen one by one so that interns who will watch this video will be able to execute setting up a laptop after it has been re-imaged. So stay tuned and watch and follow the steps. Okay, we're back. Notice this is the laptop. This is the Latitude 21, Dell Latitude 2100, I believe it is. Let's just double check, make sure. It is. It's a Latitude 2100. And this is the model that we're using, and this is your typical student laptop. So, this laptop has already been re-imaged. And so now we've got to go through Windows and set it up and do the next process. Okay, so here's what we're going to do first. You're going to open up the laptop and you're going to go ahead and, well, before you even power it on, go ahead and make sure it has power and that your Ethernet cable is connected so that it will have access to the internet. And you want to go ahead and power it on. Make sure it has a good power supply and press the power button and power it on. Here you will see that the Windows screen is loading. And always watch the screen, for this one says please wait. So that means that the screen is getting prepared and getting ready. And on an average work day, you could probably go ahead and set up 2 or 3 once you get the hang of it and save time and get it going. So your first screen is your Welcome to Microsoft Windows. And then you will hear the sound, and I have the volume down a little bit, but there's a nice little song that plays. All right, so the next thing you want to do after your Welcome to Microsoft Windows screen is put your pointer on Next and click the green button for Next. Try to only click it once, because sometimes when you double click, it'll bypass a screen. Your second screen is the End User License Agreement. Here, once you scroll through, and typically we as a county have already accepted these agreements, so the only thing we have to do here is just click Yes, I accept, and click Next. The next screen is the license screen, to where we key in the key code to make sure that we register the product. So I'm going to key in the key code. However, I may not put the key code on the screen just in case this video gets in the wrong hands. And so now, what's your computer name? Here we are. This is where we name the laptop itself. So what we do, our naming scheme is NV for North Advance underscore, and then we put in the service tag. So you want to go here and prepare this particular screen to be edited. And let's get backspace out of the original service tag that came with the image. We'll lift this laptop up, and normally your service tag is on this white label, which may be hard to read in this particular video, but I'm just showing you the logistics or the procedure of how to locate the service tag. So you may have to flip back a couple times. You might want to go ahead and put on your caps lock key. Okay, and you want to make sure you go ahead and do the duplicate name for computer description as well. And I'm going to do underscore S for student. Once you finish with what's your computer name screen, which is name of the screen, you want to go ahead and click next. And so what's happening now, I'm making sure that cable is in. The Ethernet cable is in. And so here we go. We're going to key in the administrator password. Which I will give to you. And then we're going to confirm it. Once that's done, and that screen is the administrator password screen, then we'll go to next. And then it asks if this computer, this is your domain screen, it asks if your computer will be joining a domain, and yes. So we fix this field for editing. And we key in VCS because that's the name of our domain. I go to next. And so this particular screen asks, enter the name or the password of a user who's authorized to join. So here's where we actually join the domain. So normally we put in VCS backslash. Let's get rid of that. Let's take the caps lock key off, VCS backslash, and since you will be an intern, let's use intern, and then you will key in the password for the intern username, which I will give you, and then we'll click next. So the laptop is checking internet connectivity, so that's why it's important that you have your Ethernet cable plugged in. And so will this computer connect to the internet directly or through a network? We'll say yes through a local network. And then that option stays the same, and then we click next. And then this screen, which is the next to the last screen, ready to register with Microsoft. We, since we did it as a, excuse me, as a district, we'll say no, not at this time, and click next. And that's it. The next screen says thank you, congratulations. You are ready to get, you are ready to go. Here's what you've just accomplished. Your computer is configured for internet access. And so now we've set it up for Windows, and so we click finish. There you have it. And that's how you set up your laptop once you have re-imaged it and connected to the internet.